Ladies and gentlemen, honored guests, will you please rise for the academic procession and remain standing for O Canada.
Oshem Nishia, Harrison the Holmuchin, Nanurex, Hollowin, CM the Sierra, Stetson the Eight Star, Mitsin Sierra, Heightin, Hollowin, CM, Heights, Cassium, Tinamistake, it's a great inam at one muskum tumuk, one on a quam quam, Swallowin, CM, Gitalum, CM, Gitalum, CM, Heights, Cassium, Tinamistake, Nate, Chalkon tumuk, Nate, Emequa, Harrison, one muskum tulumuk. How does the whole musquat squish? What's the name? What's the name? Nay, hi, ton of squares can eat the muck, and how does them eat an anna? Nay, cock the manama, no, an anna, I swear, see him. How does the name, title of name, chalk on tumuk? How does them, my man? On behalf of the Musqueam Nation, we welcome you to our traditional territories. On this special day, it is the day of our young adults as their graduation is happening. We are very honored to be here, and you as our guest of the Musqueam Nation, on the school we call Nanewit. I'm going to sing a song that comes from deep in the mountains from my aunt's territories. So thank you and enjoy your day. Hey-ya, hee-o, ya, hee-o, ya, hee-o. Hey-ya, hee-o, hee-o. Oh, hey, hey, ah, hey, ah, oh, oh, hey, ah, hey, ah, oh, oh, hey, ah, hey, oh, oh, hey, oh, oh, hey, hey, ah, hey, ah, oh, oh, hey, ah, hey, ah, oh, oh, hey.
Holy, oh, says, Nam,
Oh, Canada, our home and native land, true patriot love in all our sons command. With glowing hearts we see thee rise, the true North strong and free. From far and wide, O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. God keep our land glorious and free. O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. Stand on guard for thee.
Thank you, Emily. Emily Wilson is a student in our Theater Arts Studio 58 program. Please be seated. Mr. President, representatives of the board, members of the faculty and staff, honored guests, graduands, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Langara College and thank you for joining us today. I declare open this 2016 convocation of Langara College. This convocation is assembled for the granting of credentials and awarding of honors. My name is Margaret Heldman. I am the acting provost and vice president of academics and students at Langara College, and it is my deep pleasure to be your master of ceremonies today. Please be aware that this ceremony is being recorded for viewing in other locations on campus and on our website. On behalf of the Langara College community, I wish to acknowledge with respect the history, customs, and culture of the Coast Salish peoples, specifically the Musqueam Nation, on whose traditional lands we are meeting today. At this time, I would like to introduce the members of our platform party. I ask that you please hold your applause until everyone has been introduced. Dr. Lane Trotter, President and Chief Executive Officer. Ms. Lenora Gates, Board of Governor. Ms. Jessie Smith, Director, Langara Faculty Association. Mr. Victor Soka, Vice President, Administration and Finance. Ms. Gail Sparrow, former Chief of Musqueam First Nations and Langara Elder in Residence. Dr. Mark Winston, Professor and Senior Fellow, Simon Fraser University, and today's keynote speaker. Dr. Martin Gerson, retired Vice President, Academic and Provost, who will be awarded the Emeritus designation at today's ceremony. Mrs. Gerda Kraus, Board Governor, Chair of Education Council, and Division Chair, Mathematics and Sciences. Dr. Leela Dawson, Dean, Faculty of Social Sciences and Management. Dr. Julie Longo, Dean, Faculty of Arts. Ms. Dawn Palmer, Vice President, People Services. Mr. A.J. Patel, Associate Vice President, International and External Development. Mrs. Moira Gookstetter, Director, College Advancement and Executive Director, Langara College Foundation. Mr. Clayton Monroe, Dean of Student Services and Registrar. Dr. Jim Bowers, Division Chair, Community Programs. Mr. Robin McQueen, Division Chair, Health Sciences. Ms. Janine Lennox, Chair, School of Nursing. Dr. Dana Maslovat, Department Chair, Kinesiology. Dr. Todd Stuckless, Program Coordinator, Engineering Transfer. I would also like to acknowledge the representatives from the Langara Student Union who've joined us in the audience for today's ceremony. At this time, I invite Gail Sparrow, former Chief of Musqueam First Nations and Langara Elder in Residence, to bring traditional territorial greetings. Thank you.
Every time I follow her, I always have to bring the mic down. You get the long and the short of things. Welcome to the traditional territory of the Musqueam First Nations, to Langara Sanewath Lalem, which means House of Teachings, a name that was blessed upon the school by the Musqueam First Nations just this year, January the 12th. I have to also acknowledge that we have in our presence the president of Langara, Lane Trotter, who was blessed with an Indian name, Stakaya, which means wolf. Wolves traveled in packs and in family, and the strong wolf was always the leader of the pack, so we've got the best of the pack leader here, Dr. Lane Trotter, and also our elder from Musqueam, Henry Charles, who drummed you in, a respected elder. And also acknowledge here this fine-looking elder here in the front seat that is here for our family, I'm sure. We would call you our te in our language that's here for supporting your family. And also acknowledge our First Nation students here that are graduating today. Musqueam is a strong nation. We've resided here from time immemorial. And our history of Musqueam is long, long, long history of a strong people, wise people, an enduring people, people who have followed traditions of their singing and their art and their culture, and also, more importantly, the ethics of their work and their education. When I was a young girl rising in my family of 10, I was taught, when I walked by these long homes, long houses, they were long houses, just like this college is a big institution. We had in our communities institutions called long houses, and there you learned about who you are, where you were going. And you learned about respect and integrity and honesty. You learned about work. You learned about education. You learned about who you are, where you came from, where you're going. You learned your history. And one time I asked my grandfather, where is our history? Because we don't hear much in the books and we don't read much in the books. We know about what happened during the terrible, tragic things in Truth and Reconciliation, the residential schools, but where is our history? And his good knowledge, he said to me, it is written in the earth. So Langara College, this first convocation where you drummed in a traditional drumming and singing of the name Sanewath Lalem and a convocation led by First Nations. You're also being educated and graduating from a school that has rich history beneath the earth. The very history of the school is written beneath the earth. And all the students here from South Asian students that are going back home with this degree in their nursing, you'll be carrying with you also a certificate of the school of Sanewath Lalem with you. Historically, in a moment of graduating from a school that has got rich heritage and knowledge and culture in the school. And we're honored to share that with you. It's our legacy of that we will live on longer in the work that we do together. It's more importantly in education, because education is the key to your future, as taught to me by my grandfather. When I graduated in 1971 from high school, I was very rare for ones to graduate. But I kept my certificate. When I get my moments where I don't feel so worthwhile, or I get disappointed, or I don't feel like I'm accomplishing anything, and even though they call me an elder, it just lets you know the hair dye doesn't work when I use the gray. So to let you know that that certificate, take it out. Take it out and look at it. Look what you achieved and you accomplished from a school called Langara Sanewath Lalem. I do that with mine, and it helps me, even though I went to grade 12, it still was an accomplishment, an achievement, and I was not made to be a quitter. To the students from the Musqueam First Nations, we give you a message. Don't be quitters. Be winners. That's what Langara graduates as, winners. So take that with you. And if you get the moment you think that you're really not worth anything, you don't know where you're going, take out your certificate. Look at it. Know why you went to school, why you came here to learn, especially in nursing, because nursing is such an important profession. It's helping people and caring for people. So the Musqueam people want to thank also that your families have come forward to support you, because we believe it's also what takes a village. So Haichka to the family members that have come here and supported the children that are graduating here today from Langara College. We leave you our message that Musqueam people are a people of great strength and of great wisdom, and we reside not more than 10 minutes from here, a village of 400 acres, 1,200 people, welcoming people, still strong, and still going forward and working together. And we're honored that we're part of the ceremony. So we give to you our love, we give to you our welcome, we give to you our warmth, and we leave you with the blessing that they will go forward now and be who you're meant to be, because you're not meant to be nothing. We leave these blessings upon you, and I say all to all of you to raise your hands and say to each other, Haichka, Haichka CM, for being here today. We leave this message from the Musqueam First Nations. Haichka, thank you.
Thank you, Gail, for that important greeting. We value our relationship with the Musqueam Nation and appreciate your participation today. I now invite Lenora Gates, board member of the Langara Board of Governors, to bring greetings to the convocation.
Good morning, everyone. So pleased to be here. I'm proud to be part of Langara and your Board of Governors, and Dr. Trotter, the faculty, staff, our successful graduates of 2016, and very proud families, welcome. It's truly an honor to be here and to recognize you today. You know, education truly is a gift, and I believe a pathway to freedom. I was not so fortunate. I grew up in a very small town in BC, and the family wasn't poor, but we certainly by no means were rich, and it was about putting food on the table and clothes on our backs. It wasn't even a conversation really at that stage around the table. I did, however, get my grade 12 and went on with my career in real estate, got my real estate license, and then carried on with my agent's license so that I could grow my real estate business across the country. I appreciate the importance of education and have been fortunate to able to put both of my children through school and give them the gift of post-secondary. You are very, very fortunate to participate and benefit from a fantastic place of learning, Langara College, where the motto is knowledge is freedom. You've reached this milestone through perseverance, dedication, and hard work. You've proven the ability to start and finish a project, a task, and this will provide very, very important skills for you as you go forward. It helps in guiding you to be healthy, happy individuals, partners, and part of your community. Today is about celebrating your milestone, and now you embark on the next phase of your journey. The journey of life is always going to include learning and growing. The only constant in life is change, and so I encourage you to never stop learning and never stop growing. This will help you with your personality, both in your personal life and in your professional life. Before I close, I just wanted to share something with you, words of a young man from Africa that so very much wanted to go to college but did not have the funds. A friend of mine took it upon herself, she believed in him so strongly, that she decided among her friends that she wanted to raise the money so that this young man could go on to college. And this is all within the last 2 weeks. Within 2 weeks, through crowdfunding, we were able to raise the money so that he will embark on his journey in university. As a thank you note to me, he wrote, "My dream almost died. Because of her, her generous friends and contacts, my dream is still alive. And because of that, I will achieve my dream. I would like to leave this quote with you," he said. "There is no light without darkness, and yet there is no darkness without light. And I have both within me. Education is my movement from darkness to light. I wish each and every one of you the hope that you will find your own light. So it is an honor and a privilege to offer you the graduating class of 2016 on behalf of the Board of Governors, Langara College, our chair, Quinn Grauer, and much success as you head on to the phase of your next journey. Thank you all very, very much for being part of the success of Langara College, and I wish you all the best.
Thank you very much, Lenora. I am now pleased to call upon President Lane Trotter, who will bring greetings.
Thank you, Margaret. Good morning, everyone. Platform party, colleagues, graduands, and guests, welcome to the 2016 convocation ceremony of Langara College Snowaeth Leilum. Snowaeth Leilum is the name given to Langara in January of this year by the Musqueam people on whose unceded traditional territory the college is located. We use both names to acknowledge that Langara has both a First Nations and European heritage and identity. We were honored to be given this name, which means House of Teachings, appropriate given our focus on teaching excellence. Langara College is a special place that helps students pursue their goals, whether it is to further studies, gaining the skills to enter the labor market, or to career transition and advancement. Since Langara's inception, which can be traced back to 1965, the college has always focused on helping students achieve their goals. But from our beginning, whether it was in temporary facilities until our current campus opened in 1970, or when we became an independent institution in 1994, students are the center of all we do. And to date, Langara has over 100,000 alumni, including international students from more than 75 countries, who have gone on to pursue their dreams and add to the richness and diversity of our society. Their talents have made our community a better place, and in turn, the community has continued to place its trust in Langara to educate and train not only the next generation of young people, but to also provide support to those seeking new pathways to a better future. However, we would not be here today celebrating the success of our graduands without the people that have supported them during their education. We need to thank those, many of whom are here today, who helped you while you pursued your studies, whether it was your parents, other family members, spouses and significant others, or even friends. I particularly want to thank our faculty and staff for their dedication and commitment, for they have been essential to your education and success. Finally, I also want to acknowledge and thank our Langara College Foundation and those members from our community who have donated funds to create scholarships and bursaries to support student success. They have all played a role in helping our students be here today. So on behalf of the graduating class, I want to publicly thank all of you for the support you have provided. To our students, you've achieved a milestone in being here today, but before you leave, I want to take this opportunity and offer you some counsel. In October of 2015, I had the privilege to listen to the Assembly of First Nations National Chief Perry Balgard speak about closing the gap between First Nations, Aboriginal and Indigenous peoples and the rest of Canada. Chief Balgard indicated that there are over 634 First Nations in Canada speaking 58 different languages, and that Indigenous peoples comprise 4.3% of the total population of Canada. Aboriginal and Indigenous youth are also the fastest growing demographic within Canada, and more Aboriginal people are moving off reserves. Our Aboriginal peoples form an important and foundational part of our country that we as a society have not always or even often honored. The recommendations of the Truth and Reconciliation Commission provide a framework for engagement and rapprochement with First Nations that we as a country must seize so that Aboriginal and Indigenous people, including the Métis, are fully included in the fabric of our society. We are working hard to build a foundation of respect and reciprocity between Langara, Musqueam, and all the Indigenous students that we serve that will help to move us forward towards reconciliation. We are at a unique historical point where the recommendations of the Truth and Reconciliation Commission can help us move forward to address past wrongs and build a brighter future for our First Nations, Aboriginal and Indigenous youth, as well as for all Canadians, landed immigrants, and permanent residence. As you leave Langara today, pursue your path, recognize the opportunities that you've been provided, and consider how each of you can contribute to the process of reconciliation. We need you to become involved, contribute your passion and knowledge to build a more prosperous, sustainable, and fair society. So my challenge to you, the graduating class of 2016, is to be engaged and make a difference, to build a better society that includes all Canadians, First Nations, Aboriginal, Indigenous peoples, landed immigrants, and permanent residents, who add to the rich tapestry of our society. So as you move forward in your life and career, be open to the possibilities, expected and unexpected, that will emerge in your journey. But whatever you do, be involved, be active, and make a difference. Thank you for your time and patience. Enjoy your day. You've earned it. Tomorrow the work begins. Thank you, Haichka, and good luck.
Thank you, President Trotter. At this time, Jesse Smith, board member of the Langara Faculty Association, will bring greetings to convocation from the faculty. Jesse?
I really do need to lower this. Good morning, everyone. Wow, you guys look awesome. Much nicer than sometimes you do in our classes. It's a real honor for me to speak to you today on behalf of all faculty. As your teachers, we just love to see the light of learning in your eyes. When you get a new concept, or when you master a new skill, or when you teach us things, we are filled with pride and joy. To get here today, we know that you have all worked very hard. You've had a lot of stress, you've pulled all-nighters. We really know this because we've heard all about it in our office hours. In this context, it's kind of difficult sometimes to remember that, in fact, you are among the most lucky people in the world. Only 7% of the world's population gets a college education. Yes, I'm ever the educator. I had to throw that little bit in there. It'll be on the quiz next week. But graduates, you deserve this education. It is your human right, but it is also a responsibility. We hope that you will go out into the world and use your Langaran education wisely. We have taught you different subjects, but we have all taught you the critical thinking, reading, research, and writing skills that you will need to thrive in all aspects of your life. One of the greatest desires that we have for you is that you will make decisions using evidence as your guiding principle. We kind of hounded this into you, you know, in every essay and every exam. It is a fierce commitment to seeking out the truth of things and to continue to educate yourself that will set you apart. I look across this room and I see a sea of possibility. I see seeds of hope. And I see in you the possibility that each of you, in your own small way, will help build a better future for everyone. Right now, you're focused on questions such as, what am I going to do with my life? Those are good things to be pondering now. I know that you will find your way to something that will fill you with joy. Hopefully, it'll be through paid work, but if it's not, it'll be through your volunteer work or a hobby. It doesn't matter where it comes, as long as that it fills you up and it gives you an opportunity to give back to your community in some way. But please remember that great joy will also come from the little things in life. It may sound cliche, but you really should stop and smell the roses, both literally and figuratively. Try not to get so busy that you don't have time to enjoy each delicious moment that life has to offer. You'll have more time now that you're not studying to do that. So please keep in touch with your teachers. We love to hear from you. Come by and say hi, write us a line, write us an email. We want to know where life takes you. So thank you, graduates, for all your hard work. We're so proud of you, and congratulations to you all.
Thank you, Jesse. I now ask President Trotter to present today's Convocation Awards.
Thank you, Margaret. It is with great pleasure that I present today's awards. The Governor General's Collegiate Bronze Medal is awarded to the student graduating from a two-year program at Langara with the highest cumulative grade point average. The Langara College Graduate Excellence Award for Arts and Science is awarded to the student graduating from a two-year Arts and Science program with the highest cumulative grade point average. This year, the recipient of both of these awards is Zikon Fan. Zikon, can you please join us on stage? Zikon remembers his first term at Langara College. It was hard, it was tiring, and he was nervous. But his curiosity and sense of adventure made it a successful one. Zikon compares his studies with exploring the world. Whenever he finished a course, more possibilities would appear. And with every possibility he pursued, more opportunities were possible. With the help of his instructors, his friends, and his study groups, Zikon is graduating with a cumulative grade point average of 4.25. Now that he's completed his associate degree, Zikon plans to complete an undergraduate degree and then apply for graduate school. Congratulations, Zikon. Emeritus is Latin for having merited one's discharge by service. It is an honorary title conferred to retired faculty or professional staff to recognize their distinguished service to an organization. At this ceremony, we honor Martin Gerson, Vice President, Academic, and Provost Emeritus. Martin, would you please step forward while I introduce you? Martin's remarkable 38-year career at Langara, spanning five decades and two centuries, was characterized by distinguished service as a mathematics faculty member, faculty association president, division chair, dean of instruction, and finally as the college's first vice president, academic, and provost. His service to the college constitutes an unparalleled contribution in the history of the institution. Throughout his career, Martin was highly respected and warmly regarded by the Langara community as an ethical leader and a trusted colleague who embodied our highly valued collegial model. Congratulations, Martin.
Thank you, Lane, and congratulations to Zikon and to Martin. It is now my pleasure to introduce to you Dr. Mark Winston, who will give today's convocation address. Dr. Winston has had a distinguished career researching, teaching, writing, and commenting on bees and agriculture, environmental issues, and science policy. Dr. Winston's work has appeared in numerous books, commentary columns for the Vancouver Sun, the New York Times, the Sciences, Orion Magazine, and frequently on CBC Radio and National Public Radio. His research, communication, and dialogue achievements have been recognized by many awards, including the Manning Award for Innovation, Sterling Prize in Support of Controversy, British Columbia Gold Medal in Science and Engineering, Eve Savory Award for Science Communication, Michael Smith Award for Science Promotion, and a prestigious Killam Fellowship from the Canada Council, election as a Fellow of the Royal Society of Canada, and the 2015 Governor General's Literary Award for Nonfiction for his best-selling book, Bee Time, Lessons from the Hive. He is currently a professor and senior fellow in Simon Fraser's Center for Dialogue and a professor of biological sciences. Please extend a very warm Langara welcome to Dr. Mark Winston.
President Trotter, elders, board members, graduands, and honored guests. In a few moments, you graduands will walk across this stage, family and friends proud of what you've accomplished, and encouraging you to become all that you can be. Rather than give you advice, which I'm sure you've heard plenty of, I'd like to share with you two moments in my life. The first early on that defined what I wanted to do in the world, and the second only a few years ago that clarified why. I was a poor student in university, a borderline C average. I've yet to find a professor in any university who can claim a lower GPA than I. How I emerged from that academic lethargy is a story in itself, but I want to jump ahead to 1976. When I found myself heading to South America to study killer bees. I had no experience with bees, no idea what to expect. I'd flown from North to South America the day before, a grueling set of flights that left me disoriented. I entered the apiary fully protected from what I thought would be an onslaught of wrathful bees, wearing a layer of clothes and a bee suit, veil, and gloves. I removed the lid of the first hive. The bees were unexpectedly calm, and I began paying attention to what was going on in the beehive as my fear dissipated. The gloves came off, then the veil. I pulled the frames out one by one to inspect the combs. It was my moment when everything shifted. It's a full-body experience being among the bees. You first notice the sounds, a low hum from tens of thousands of bees flying in and out of their hives, each circling the apiary to get her bearings, and then heading off purposely in a beeline toward blooming flowers. Smells and textures bombard the senses, the sweet odors and feel of honey and beeswax. Underlying the physical sensations are collaboration and order, communication and common purpose, each bee submerging her individual nature for the colony. While I didn't know it at the time, that moment became my defining story, the moment I discovered my purpose. The messages I learned from bees were to strive to better understand our place in nature, to be fully present to the people and events surrounding us, and the power of opening our hearts and minds to a deeper appreciation of who we are as individuals, communities, and a species. My second moment, this one, a profound realization, came just a few years ago, shortly after my mother passed away. I was teaching an intensive two-week program in science communication at the Banff Center in Alberta, and at the end, we had a closing circle to share our experiences. It was a very intensive program, and as these programs go, of course, people want to share at the end. I was about three-quarters of the way around the circle, and as we got to the third and the fourth and the fifth person, I felt anxiety building, and by the time it came around to me, I was having a full-blown panic attack. This is completely unusual for me. I don't have panic attacks, but here I was having one, and when it came my turn to talk, I burst into tears. Tears of grief, because my mother had passed away only a few weeks ago, but it was also a moment of realization. My mother's childhood was difficult. Her father was a bookie. He was associated with the mob. But it was not the colorful occupation often depicted in movies. Her nuclear family was deeply troubled with poverty, abuse, mental illness, suicide, and alcohol. They were extremely poor. The family often split up, sleeping on the couches of aunts and uncles, as they were unable to pay their own rent. She married into what became a difficult relationship, one in which she was never able to build an independent, personal, and professional life. Her life was unfortunately untouched by the benefits of feminism, a movement that has vastly improved the lives of women from her time to ours. My mother was very bright, both intellectually and with extremely acute social intelligence. But she grew up in a time when women were not encouraged towards careers, and her abusive childhood left her with low self-esteem. She was unusually perceptive about others and compassionate, but hard on herself. The unresolved issues from her childhood finally caught up to her in her 40s. She became anorexic, in considerable physical pain, mental anguish, and declining health for her remaining 40 or so years. Hers was a potential unrealized, a life unfulfilled. My tears that day in Banff were partly grief, but also from finally understanding where my motivation as a teacher and mentor came from, to contribute in whatever small way I could to encouraging others to fully become the people they could be, to mentor others to expand, to completely inhabit their potential, to avoid the tragic life trajectory of her life unfulfilled that had afflicted my mother. I had worked with that in the background all my life, but until that moment, had never understood why. Moments are not our full stories, but it is when we begin to grow our life stories from those moments that we define who we are and who we want to be in the world. From bees, I learned the power of presence and being fully in those moments. And from my mother's unfulfilled history, grew my own commitment to mentoring others. Some of you have already had your moments, although you might not know it yet. For others, they are yet to come. But remember this, you get to decide who you want to be in the world. You get to choose the moments that will mature into your stories. Choose well, not only from self-interest, but to leave a legacy of contribution. Whatever stories you grow, your life will be richer if you choose to serve others and the planet around you. Your lives are before you. Embrace the moments. Thank you.
Mark, thank you very much for that inspiring address. On behalf of Langara College, President Trotter would like to present you with a small gift in appreciation of your excellent remarks and for the time you spent with us today. And now on to the presentation of graduands, which is why most of you are here today. President Trotter, the candidates to be presented to you today and those who are absent have fulfilled all the requirements for their respective credentials. I ask that you confer upon each the credential which he or she has earned. Will the graduands please rise?
By the authority granted to me by the government of this province, I admit you and those in absentia to the credentials to which you are entitled. Please be seated.
We will now begin the presentation of our graduates. When each graduate is announced, they will stand here near the front corner of the stage to have their first photograph taken. There's a nice blue arrow on the black carpet. You can find it. They will then be greeted by some of our platform party members on my right, and have a second photograph taken with President Trotter. Blue arrow on black carpet over here. Faculty who would like to congratulate their graduates may approach the platform to my right. Audience members who want to move closer to the front for a photograph of their graduate may come to the far aisle to my right when it is close to the time that your graduate will cross the stage. Please be mindful not to block the view of others and return to your seats afterwards so that others may approach the front for photographs. I now ask Dr. Julie Longo, Dean of the Faculty of Arts, Ms. Gerda Kraus, Division Chair of Mathematics and Sciences, and Dr. Leela Dawson, Dean of the Faculty of Social Sciences and Management, to announce the names of the graduates.
And now for the graduates of Associate of Arts degree. Alex Javier Adame Quiroga. Bold Batsuka. Derek S. Beckett. Stephanie Campbell. Jessica Marie Fletcher. Sarah M. Lung. Kai-Yun Lee. Jared Hong Lui. Tarek Mahmoud Malik. Jeannie Michelle Meredith. Sarah Caitlin Meisen. Daniel Francis Mojiroshi. Wyatt John Naylor. Chika Obayashi. Yushani Prabhakaran. Sarah Clarissa Lee Ryder. Adam Gregory Todd. Brian Yuk Kyu Wong. Graduates with Diploma in Arts and Science. Mohammed Nasif Adnan. Th- Tatiana Burr. Michael Carl Figueroa. Graduating with distinction, Sumio Kulbata. Yvonne Ying Kwok. Russell Tabunar Mejia. Amanda Marie Marazzo. Amid Nikash Najmuddin. Shireen Haley O'Connor. Kelsey Adrian Redekop. Marie Sito. Yashun Xiao. And now for the graduates with a diploma in general education. Madhyav Agarwal. And now I'd like to call on Gerda Kraus.
Graduating with an Associate of Science degree. Andrea Bernardo. Yukin Rennie Wren. Graduating with an Associate of Science degree in Bioinformatics, Cooperative Education. Roshan Anthony Narona. Zhi Kon Fan. Andrew Ross McKenzie Gazin. Graduating with a diploma in computer science in computer studies. Wei Kin Arthur Chow. Yan Lin Wang. Graduating with a diploma in computer studies, cooperative education. Christy Lee Anan. Jacob McCray. Associate of Science degree in General Biology. Alexander Fei Hang Yi. Associate of Arts degree in Health Sciences. Priyanka Maria Krishna. Michelle Sham. Graduating with a diploma in human kinetics. Martin Raphael Abel. Brandon Kyle Cardinal. Ronaldo Sanchez. Spiro Patrick Spittle. Ian Carlo Rivera. Diploma in Kinesiology. Ikal Singh Birya. Terence Chung. Nicholas Jordan Fung. Megan Marie Jameson. Navjot Kaur. Gabriella Leong. Luis Lopez Marquez. Julius Caesar Panera. Carmen Schum. Abigail Valienta Sign. Edward M. Chow Hang Ko. Sun Trin. Graduating with a post-degree certificate in nursing leadership and management. Harpreet Kaur Dhaliwal. Deepika Dutt. Graduation with distinction, Amanpreet Kaur. Graduation with distinction, Hardeep Kaur. Jaskiran Kaur. Jatinder Kaur. Sarnjeet Kaur. Victor Grayfield Lilang. Sandeep Kaur Kehel. Sanvir Kaur Sangha. Mandeep Kaur Sidhu. Ramanjot Kaur Tawana. Graduating with a post-degree diploma in nursing practice in Canada. Monica. Ritu Bala. Jaspreet Kaur Bagri. Ruben Bala. Andrew Daniel. Andrew Daniel. Kulvir Kaur Diol. Norbi Dolma. Navneet Kaur Garcha. Dilbar Singh Gill. Harpreet Kaur Gill. Karamjeet Kaur Gill. Kevin Deep Singh Gill. Ramandeep Kaur Gill. Simrandeep Kaur Januha. Amanpreet Kaur. Harpreet Kaur. Kulmojeet Kaur. Kirandeep Kaur. Mehak Meet Kaur. Navjot Bir Kaur. Paramveer Kaur. Rashpal Kaur. Rupinder Kaur. Gagandeep Khan. Fengwei Fiona Ku. Gagandeep Kaur Pander. Jaspinder Kaur Panu. Navjot Kaur Panu. Mary Paul. Harpreet Kaur Sandhu. Navpreet Sandhu. Rajdeep Kaur Sidhu. Tenzin Yang Chen. Graduating with an Associate of Science degree.
First group is graduating with a diploma in arts and science in Asian studies. Laura Steger. And with an Associate of Arts degree in Geography, graduating with distinction, Ryan Douglas Land. With an Associate of Arts degree in History, Veronica Isabel Leyva Mejia. Gershwin Na Tan. An Associate of Arts degree in Political Science, Erica Michaela Cueno Padojenog. An Associate of Arts degree in Psychology, Keith Adrian Aladia. Marisa Alexandra Artiga. Nikki Ariel Star Barnes. Robin Colin Alexander Barrett. Amy Sela F. Cadano. Larissa Heather Grace Dixon. Graduating with distinction, Nadine Elizabeth Ayer. Cheyenne Nika Denisha Lopez. Anthony Ronald Verdo. Michelle Bernadette Warden.
Ladies and gentlemen, your graduates of 2016. As we bring this morning's ceremony to a close, I would like to take a moment to thank our theater arts student, Emily Wilson, who sang O Canada. Theater arts graduate, Masai Day, who provided the music prior to the ceremony. Mike McDonald, the piper who led our procession. And Henry Charles, the Musqueam elder who led our platform party. I would also like to extend our deep appreciation to the many college employees whose contributions have made this a memorable event. It is also my pleasure, on behalf of the college and the Langara Students' Union, to invite you to a reception in the Langara Students' Union building immediately after the ceremony. Masai will also be playing for us there.
Would you please rise and remain standing until the graduates have left the convocation hall? I now declare this convocation closed.